We're at the same outcrop as in the previous shots, but rather than looking at an airplane view as we were up at the top, we're now looking at a cross-section of the outcrop. And what you can see in the cross-section is the syncline that we saw up at the top. Shannon's at the axis of the syncline, Dustin and Allie on each side, and you can see the beds nicely define the syncline. Now, if we go over in this direction, you can see the beds dip up, and then they dip back down, and that's an anticline right there. So we have a syncline and then an anticline. What causes a syncline and anticline? Well, remember from class, it's compression. You squeeze the rocks and you're going to fold the rocks into synclines and anticlines. So now we're looking at that anticline again. You can see the anticline right here. But there's another geologic feature that's well illustrated here. And Dustin's going to point it out. Notice that line right there that he's pointing out. That is a fault. So when you have compression, you will initially fold rocks. Push rocks together, they're going to fold. But if the compression continues, continually to compress them, what's likely to happen is the rocks will break and you will produce a fault, as you can see right up there. And when a fault occurs, you're going to get an earthquake.